And they found you amusing for a while.
The people of this city. But the one thing they love more than a hero is to see a hero fail, fall, die trying. In spite of everything you've done for them.
This past month has definitely been Mr. Beast's worst month of his life. He first had his best friend, Chris Aver Tyson, get outed out as a pedophile, and now he is getting cancelled.
Here, right here, all your needs will be met.
I'm hungry!
Dogpack404 was a former Mr. Beast employee, and he's released two videos on Mr. Beast, and they've both gained over 10 million views, and it's just basically showing how unethical Mr. Beast's company is. So one of the biggest claims during the first video was that Mr. Beast was running illegal lotteries for children, basically.
It's insane that he can flip these massively profitable illegal lotteries targeted towards children as an act of generosity.
I'm going to give you guys a few minutes to go place an order at shopmrbeast.com. Anyone watching any of the lives. And we're going to throw iPhones in some of them.
Mr. Beast just uses gambling psychology to exploit young children for profit. He's just become the first casino where the currency you pay with is attention.
He also talks about how manipulative Mr. Beast's YouTube channel actually is and how it runs.
One is getting the viewer to associate the brand with trust and authority. Mr. Beast videos are real, and he's a great guy that gives away big rewards to his loyal followers. Step two is showing the viewers that when people interact with Mr. Beast in a way that benefits Mr. Beast, when they do what he tells them to do, they win big rewards. And step three is finally calling on the viewer to act in some way that benefits the brand, promising big rewards in return. Now it's your turn to do what Mr. Beast tells you, and you will win big rewards.
Dogpack also shows how these Mr. Beast videos are faked, like CGI, like people just acting in his videos.
This train track is CGI, these bus wheels are CGI, this explosion is fake, this shredder is CGI, this car is digitally lifted, this pit is fake, this guy is fake, this raccoon is a paid actor, sure, this island costs more than $1, this city is not abandoned, these buildings are CGI, but it's not your only way out, you can literally get an Uber to the airport for $20. That's not a lurker, it's just a guy. This whole room is fake, this contestant is an actor and a secret employee at Mr. Beast, they had him die through this fake door twice, this line is scripted, this action is scripted, in fact, pretty much all the videos with Mac are scripted.
I used to look up to you, man. How could you do this? How could you do this, bro?
I think one of the bigger things Dogpack exposes here is that not all random subscribers get to be in his video. If you actually look into it, it's really just friends and family of employees, like Mac, for example. So when he says subscribed and you have a chance to be in the video, it's just a lie.
Wait, he's about to be the first one out? That's unlike him.
Even though you got out first, I still have a prize for you. Just wait here.
Oh, first person out gets a car, and it just happened to be your friend Mac.
He also talks about how Mr. Beast doesn't live up to his promises. There's been some contestants who've won in the past and just didn't receive their prize. And then there's also an incident when people paid $10 for Mr. Beast to put a photo on the moon, and it just didn't work out.
Just to keep things fun and interesting, as if putting a photo on the moon isn't interesting enough. Someone who puts a photo on the moon, or if you buy the bundle, whatever, in the next 30 minutes, we'll just fly you down to be in a video.
3 years later, the spaceship finally launched, carrying beautiful pictures of deceased loved ones to the moon, where they would be immortalized. It fucking exploded. So obviously Mr. Beast refunded everyone, right? Right? Is it Mr. Beast's fault that the rocket exploded? No. Is it his fault that he advertised it as for $10 I will put your photo on the moon?
For $10 I'll put whatever picture you want on the moon.
When he couldn't guarantee that? Yes, of course.
You can't keep getting away with it!
So one of the reasons why Mr. Beast was accused of illegal lotteries was the fact that when you actually have a lottery or a competition, you're supposed to have a no purchase necessary, which is basically someone can enter into your lottery for free.
To celebrate our launch of milk chocolate and sea salt, we went out, we bought 10 Teslas, loads of cash, and all these prizes you see on the screen. And prizes aside, unlike Hershey's, These bars only have 4 to 5 ingredients and just genuinely taste good. Go to Feastables.com right now and order some chocolate. Only problem is the chocolate river is deteriorating. All the
The only place you'll find no purchase necessary is either on the Feastables Twitter account because it's a rule of the platform, and even still they try to push it. No perch neck. Or hidden deep in the Feastables website under a FAQ. And to enter for free, you have to mail in separate 3-inch by 5-inch hand-addressed written index cards, up to 10 a day.
So when I watched this first video, I didn't think it was that bad. Like, yes, it ruins Mr. Beast's image, but it wouldn't get him canceled. But because of how much traction the video got, with over 10 million views, people had a lot of stories, bad stories about Mr. Beast. And a former employee called Jake Weddle, he came out and he talked to Dogpack, and they released the second video, and it is looking really bad for Mr. Beast now.
Oh my God! Okay, it's happening. Everybody, stay calm.
What's the procedure, everyone? What's the procedure?
Stay calm.
Wait, everybody, calm down.
After posting, I got hundreds of messages from former Mr. Beast employees, and I had them all like send proof of former employment. You know, just people showing their support or telling their stories of you know, fake videos or unsafe practices, you know, toxic workplace, stuff like that. I'm not really going to get into those claims because, for one, like, most people want to stay anonymous, which I understand. During the 100 Boys versus Girls video, I have people corroborating the same story that the camera guy who gave the girls a drone was making some girls feel uncomfortable. You know, you trap these girls in a circle and make them sleep on rough turf and get them high on paint fumes, and then you try to f*** them.
Ew, you nasty-ass bastard! You fucking nasty-ass motherfucker! That's nasty, man!
So yeah, then he gets into his interview with Jake Weddle.
Most people who, if you know me from Mr. Beast, I'm a deep cut. I'm in a few of the videos, sometimes maybe purposefully kept to the shadows a little bit. I'm in the cutting room floor a lot of the time. But I've been in some videos, I've worked on a lot of them. I was there from 2019 to 2020, 2021-ish when I came back and did some more. I was there when they were authentic, and then I saw the transition to what I feel like is a company. He's like a TV show now. It went from YouTuber guy with a camera to Amazon.
So yeah, then Jake describes the working culture there. Basically, if Mr. Beast liked you, you'd get paid more, and if he didn't like you, well, too bad.
Culture around there was very unspoken, but there was a vibe. There was half the people who, if you made Jimmy happy, you were on the good half, and these people got random bonuses and were usually moved up, had more screen time. And then there was people who, if you had a disagreement or butt heads with Jimmy, or just you didn't like it, you know, you were the other half. I consistently was in the half that Jimmy doesn't like me. That's fine. I don't like him either. It's okay. Oh, that's also good to say. I don't like Jimmy. I hate you so much.
So one thing Mr. Beast does is he claims his videos aren't fake. They're very real. And Jake quickly debunks that.
I wanted to do a prank where, unbeknownst to the person, he takes a rock, crushes their car, and they're supposed to think a rock came out of space.
We're gonna take a meteor and we're gonna put it on Weddle's car. We're gonna take another meteor and put it on Marcus's car. Both of them have no idea that we're doing this. Weddle and Marcus are probably shocked. They had no idea.
And so that was the one and only time I had to, huh? My car? What?
That's cheating! That's cheating!
So Jake says he, after they destroyed his car, they gave him $10,000 to make a down payment for a new car, but really, like, $10,000 is just not enough for, like, a new car, and he says he doesn't even make enough money at Mr. Beast to even afford to, like, continue to pay for an even better car.
They're supposed to give me $10,000 to put a down payment on a new car, and they wanted me to get, like, a big, flashy new car. $10,000 was supposed to be a down payment. Can't afford a big, flashy new car, because I work at Mr. Beast. So I couldn't get anything I couldn't afford the taxes on, I couldn't get anything I couldn't afford the insurance on. So I do my part of the video, and I get a mom van that I could afford. And Jimmy was like, why didn't you get a cooler car? I was like, I can't afford that, bro. Come on, what are you talking about?
So as Jake mentioned before, his pay was really bad, but he then mentioned that he worked with another writer, a black guy, and that black guy received less pay than him. And he was assuming maybe it's because of racism.
There was another writer there. Older comic, black guy, he had a kid, and I got paid more than him, and I thought that was wild because he was older than me, had a child, we're doing the exact same job, and well, I'm some 20-year-old white guy. Why am I getting paid more than him? I brought that up.
I will say here that Jake mentions that they did the same job, but I don't know if that guy was actually on camera like Jake was, because if Jake was on camera and writing, then I can understand why he got paid more. But if that guy was also on camera, then yeah, that's pretty messed up. But anyways, Jake decided to do something about this and thought that it was unfair. So he went into the office with him and discussed it to the management and said, hey, we want the same pay. But then they just decided to let him go.
But he said, hey, man, if that's how you feel, you know, like if that's like, I trust you. He stood with me. He went to that writer's, he went to that meeting with me. And I said my piece and he backed me up. And I said, I need XYZ or I'm out of here. And they said, bet. And they gave me a severance check the next day. And they gave him a severance check the next day.
Out of pocket for that shit. Way out of pocket. What do you gain from that?
Me, I was over the moon. I was like, you're gonna give me a check and I get to leave? You know, I don't get to deal with how many Orbeez can I fit up my asshole every day, you know? And I get to go home and you're gonna pay me to leave. I was over the moon. And he was devastated. He did not want. That's him. He's wanting to be in the room, you know?
So the next part of this video gets even more messed up. Basically, there was a video uploaded in 2020 where it was a challenge. You stay in this room and each day you stay in there, you get $10,000. And Jake talks about this wasn't the first time they did it. It was actually on him the first time they did it. And the reason it wasn't uploaded was because of how badly it went.
People don't know that was the second attempt. The first attempt was on me. And it didn't go well. It was a terrible facility. I mean, it was in one of the studios. They had to like get like a separate like tank for, you know, septic stuff. Yeah, there was a hot tub in it. Yeah, there was an ice cream machine. Like things were cool and funny on paper. But when you think about stuff, a hot tub that's not connected to a filtration system, give it 3 days, it's gonna stink.
So as bad as the room smelled, they actually were refusing to even turn off the lights for him, so Jake couldn't get any sleep when he was there. And when Jake begged them to turn the lights off, they basically said no because they want a time-lapse shot.
They weren't turning the lights off. You know, I asked them, I said, can we like have like nighttime hours? You know? And they said no because it would fuck up the time-lapse shots. The time lapse of what? Me sleeping? Or me not sleeping? I wasn't sleeping. I could not sleep. And I have insomnia problems now. But they might have started there.
And as you can see here in the video that was actually uploaded, there was nighttime hours because of how bad it was for Jake. So in case you didn't know how bad this actually was, it's actually a war crime to deprive sleep from a terrorist and is actually not allowed at all. So it's actually a war crime that Mr. Beast did this.
And I go up to my friend, my good friend. And I go, they're not turning the lights off. He goes, what? That's a war crime. We're not allowed to do that to terrorists. Oh, good. 24 hours breaking the Geneva Convention, I guess, is what we're doing.
He also talks about how Mr. Beast fakes his reactions from when he gives money to people.
When I'm receiving some cash, Jimmy said, can you say to the camera how thankful you are that now you can pay back your student loans? You know how hard it was to do a take of that? To pretend to make it genuine.
So yeah, Jake talks about how they were faking videos, and Dogpack also talks about how they were faking videos, and Jake was just really angry at the fact that how they could fake other videos, but they just couldn't fake this one where he was getting tortured, essentially.
They're faking videos, why couldn't we fake this one? You know, if we're allowed to let these cast members have some time off of this difficult challenge, how come we couldn't turn the lights off?
This time lapse on the fourth day of 7 days stranded at sea, you can clearly see there's no one in the shelter. These are their empty beds. But after a hard cut, magically five people are awake, and two of the boys have bright yellow raincoats that they didn't have when it rained on day two.
And after standing the whole night completely soaked,
you didn't spend the night soaked, Jimmy, you slept on the production yacht. It's ironic because this is one of the videos where they claim that they don't fake things.
But no, we have to be the real channel that doesn't fake things.
Yeah, Jake also reveals Mr. Beast made a very low blow joke at the start of the challenge. He said, you're going to jail like your dad. And for people that don't know, Jake's dad is in jail right now because he sexually assaulted a minor.
What the fuck?
But he says to me, all right, you'll go to jail, you know, like your dad.
But when my friends do it, it's fine, and Jimmy wasn't my friend.
I had a very traumatic life. I have my dad is in jail for sexual assault of a minor, you know, so this kind of stuff is very near and dear to my heart. You know, I don't fuck around with this shit.
So Jake talks about how there's a rule that you can leave anytime you want, but realistically you can't, because the overwhelming pressure of staying there and doing their challenges, because if you refuse, they'll be like, oh man, you wasted all this money, there's gonna be no video, and you're probably gonna get fired as well.
Did you try to say no? Like, did you have a choice, or?
Based on the Rubik's Cube thing and based on all the other stuff, like, they gotta, there was so much pressure to just do it, just do the thing, you know? You get up, and if I refuse, it's just, well, that's the whole video, I guess the budget's, you know, so much money up in flames, because Jake said he wouldn't want to do the thing.
So not only was Jake getting barely any sleep, but he had to do all these ridiculous challenges, and the one that finally broke the straw was when Jimmy walked in, Jake was on barely any sleep, and he told him to run a marathon for extra money, and he couldn't even say no. They made him do a Rubik's Cube earlier, and he basically just said, come on, just do it. And then Jake does the marathon, and he can't even finish it, and he's on the floor, he has blisters all over his feet, and he's just done, and he taps out.
Jimmy comes in, and I'm asleep, I don't know what time it is, it's like 2 or 3 or whatever. He's like, why is he sleeping? I don't know, because I can't sleep. And he comes in, he wakes me up, and he goes, ask me why I have 2 briefcases. And I'm like, why do you have 2 briefcases? And he goes, oh, because this one's for today, you know, and this one's for the challenge. And I go, what's the challenge today? He goes, you're gonna run a marathon. You're gonna do 22.6K, whatever it is. You're gonna do it on that treadmill over there. The first challenge I did was a Rubik's Cube, and I'm dyslexic, I'm dumb. I don't know how to do a Rubik's Cube. So your first challenge, Rubik's Cube. I was like, oh, I don't wanna do it. I was like, on camera, I don't wanna do it. He goes, just do it for the thing, my kid, yeah.
So after Jake taps out, he says Mr. Beast comes in to check on him, but he gives like such a fake reaction and pretend to actually care.
He does the exact same thing when he's pretending to have a human connection. You know when you're watching a video and he's like, oh, stop, you're gonna make me cry. And he like touches his eye or whatever as if he's crying. He's just... I didn't have to pretend to do that shit. As if rehearsed by his lawyers. Yeah, you know, your mental health's the most important thing. You know, just wanna make sure you're okay. And the last thing we want you to do is... I can almost hear the word Sue come out of his mouth. The S, he just stopped right before it got out.
You would think after Mr. Beast put him through this whole thing, tortured him like this, like he can barely even walk at this point, he's barely slept, you'd think he'd feel bad and just give him all the money, but no, he didn't.
I did not get the 300K. What I got, he goes, think of it this way, at least you get to keep what you earned. You know, you were in there for XYZ days. You did XYZ challenges, so you got, you know, 100,000 some change, you know, give or take.
Yeah, Jake also shows a bunch of text messages. He basically just showing that it's actually proof that he actually went through all this stuff and how people were actually concerned for him. So moving on from Jake, Dogpack, he talks about a crazy part of the Mr. Beast employee handbook where it says no does not mean no, which is essentially the exact opposite of no means no.
Specifically on page 19, there's a paragraph called no does not mean no. Already insane, because it seems to be co-opting the popular anti-rape slogan, which is a terrible look given the allegations that are gonna be coming out very soon. It reads, when dealing with people outside Mr. Beast Productions, never take no at face value. If we need a store to buy everything inside of, and you can call the local Dollar Tree, and the person that answers says, no, you can't film here, that literally doesn't mean shit.
So things actually even get crazier towards the end of the video. It's actually revealed that Mr. Beast hired a registered sex offender, and the victim was a minor.
You have the tangible proof that he knew but covered it up. Yeah, how do you prove that, you know? Well, there was a known sex offender, registered sex offender, convicted sex offender. What I hear, I can't confirm or deny, from what I hear, he's on the registry for doing some not great stuff to some underage people. And they knew that. He's working at a channel that has underage people on and around and is targeted to underage people.
You think I didn't think of that? Of course I thought of that.
I was there, they called him Delaware. He's like, why do you call him Delaware? And I didn't know. Apparently they called him Delaware because he's not allowed to go back to Delaware.
So later on, it's revealed that Jake the Viking, a former Mr. Beast employee who's been giving Jimmy a lot of stuff, he came out saying this: yes, Delaware is my brother-in-law. Yes, he is a RSO. When he was 21, a 16-year-old girl accused him and others of sexual assault. Delaware took a plea deal. That's why there's no jail time, but he's still on the register. His name isn't Delaware because he can't go back to Delaware. He's from Delaware. That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. He's been back several times. He was hired before I was, and was actually the reason I got hired at Mr. Beast. Before being hired, Delaware sat down with Jimmy and Sue, Jimmy's mom, and explained to them everything. So yes, Jimmy knew. But again, this incident happened in 2010, and Delaware was hired in 2017/2018. Delaware was also let go from the company before I was. Delaware was supposed to be a behind-the-scenes manager, but in a couple videos he was asked to partake because we needed people. He was reluctant, especially in the straitjacket video, because of his charges, and that's why he wore the mask. Delaware charges are set to be dropped this fall. Delaware has been nothing but a good person, an amazing husband to my sister, and the best father to my two nieces that I could ever ask for. They want no part in this and want to just live their lives away from the limelight. I understand why anyone would be upset and frustrated over these allegations, and I do not blame them. Hurting kids in any way is completely unacceptable, but in the case of Delaware, I firmly believe he did nothing wrong and look forward to the day the charges are dropped. So yeah, in case you didn't know, Jake, he was shitting on Mr. Beast for protecting Chris for that whole time and saying he was protecting a pedophile, basically, and he's out here doing the same thing, which is also just crazy. So what has Mr. Beast's response been? Well, been nothing really, other than just deleting YouTube comments on his videos. It's very obvious, because if you look at negative ones and you click on it, it says something was wrong, there's an error. If you look through all of it now, it's just all positive comments.